for something.
I've never seen a taste tester. Anything like it.
I finally found a talent, guys.
Wow. Oh, that's true, man. I could not believe Money
that's
and Ralph
crazy.
Were just blown away.
Dude, I was blown away by it. I couldn't believe that anyone could tell what the difference in water is.
By the way, your senses, you have keen senses. Why didn't you ever like do anything with that?
I guess I didn't have any clue that I had keen senses.
No, but we've all, Ralph and I have always said that your job should be as a Foley artist.
I wanted to be a Foley artist.
You did.
It's really weird that you say that.
What?
When I was in junior high, I had dreamt of being a Foley artist.
Because,
I was kind of studying that, and that's how I went into radio. I was really,
really?
Yeah. But what? Interesting.
So because of the fact that, so working with you is crazy, okay? Because I probably produced. No, it is. It's sometimes frustrating because you have a process and you have like a way of how things should be, and it's fine, right? However, in one part, whenever I would work with you on a Christmas album, and I think we produced maybe three together.
Yeah,
I would never question. So the first one. You're a perfectionist, I would say, right? When it comes down to these things. So the first one, I was just kind of like, learning or whatever, and we took a long time to produce it, right? And then but the final product came out amazing. I mean, obviously, how many did you produce? How many Christmas CDs?
I would say like 11.
11. So Kevin Bean listeners, you have Lightning to help you thank for all that. Not only like lining up all the talent, producing all these things, but he's an amazing, like your ears. I would never question your method when it comes down to like producing these things or tweaking this out because you hear things that nobody else does. It's crazy. Mm. Like I've never ever worked with somebody like that. I mean, you're a pain in the ass because you make me take my time. but
how do you really feel?
But I learned from it. Do you know what I mean? It wasn't lost on me. Even though it's still like even with this podcast, you're patient with me because I tend to lose it or whatever. Because I'm not the most patient guy. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But thank you for that. I really appreciate it.
Thank you. Thank you. And I. Well, whatever you learned from me, you've definitely
turned
that into something very special because I adore your production.
Well, thanks, man. I appreciate it. And Dave did touch upon it earlier about your work ethic. It's you stay here and you make something that's not half-assed. And I think everybody at K-Rock has that kind of idea of whatever product we're going to put out is going to be top-notch at the best of our ability, no matter what.
Try.
Yeah. So, but another favorite memory of mine of Lightning's was you and Stryker on the air when an earthquake hit, and you barging in to give your 2 cents.
Oh, no.
This is super funny.
I had a couple embarrassing moments like that.
This is super funny.
No.
Radiohead's going to be at. Whoa! Did you guys just feel that earthquake? Holy mackerel. Oh, my God. Whoa! Oh, my God, there's an earthquake.
I'm not supposed to panic like that, though. Hold on.
Wow.
Okay? Yeah, I'm okay.
All right, now Lightning is already in the room. You heard the door open, and you heard him start to chuckle a little bit. It has to be 10 seconds, maybe, since the earthquake hit. Lightning is already in the studio.
Do you feel that?
Yeah. Yeah, it was crazy. By the way, did you feel that is a fantastic question to a guy who's doing nothing but talking about the earthquake. Well, Lightning, how could he not have felt it? He's 20 feet away from you.
But Bean, Lightning didn't listen when he was our producer, and he doesn't listen now. You should know that.
What was the chance he didn't feel it, Lightning? Let me ask you that. When you asked the question, what was the possibility that he would come back and say, no, I didn't feel it. What are you talking about, Light?
Listen, I can cut to the end of this conversation where you're going to make fun of me the whole time, and I have no excuse to get out of my chair and run into the air studio and try to be on the air.
But here's what's funny is that there's a gigantic police-like light right outside the door that's flashing so brightly you almost have a heart attack. There's no question whatsoever that Stryker was on the air talking at the time, so he comes running in.
Let's go back to the tape from yesterday.
Did you do it?
Yes, we're on the radio.
Yeah, it was crazy.
Oh, my. It threw me out of my seat.
I know.
That was strong. The speakers up here, I thought were going to fly and smash me in the head.
Yeah, it was nuts. I thought somebody was walking on a roof just a second ago. Wow, all right. Well, we're still in the air.
Hey, remember that time Lightning shut up? Oh, wait, that never happened.
Lightning Stryker, then he's still on the air?
Listen, it was small talk, it was banter, and it was trying to give him someone to bounce something off.
Oh, you were thinking of him and what was going through his mind at the time when you jumped in and said, "Did you feel that?"
We just had visions of people who would have panicked all over Southern California, but then they heard the calm, reassuring voice of Jay Lightning Tillis, and they thought, oh, thank God the city's in good hands.
I love that.
Yeah, no, that was a super douchey move. I don't know. I don't remember that.
That was funny.
I don't remember jumping. I don't remember it, but there were a couple instances when my desk was, Dave, in Burbank, like how far from the air studio? Probably 10 feet, 12 feet? I was the closest to
right
the air studio.
I shared a wall.
So close. And I was so used to going in there. I don't know. Maybe, I don't know. Was I a dick and wanted to be on the air? I hope not.
No, I don't think anyone thought that. It was so funny because, like being said in the tape, it's, yeah, he felt it. But the fact that you just came in and said, did you feel that? As he was talking about the shaking.
Yeah.
I heard him on the air, and it was funny.
I would have liked to chat with him about it, but he didn't really want to chat. He was just reeling in the moment. But
yeah, it was funny because in earthquakes, everybody acts different. There's the people who freak out. There's the people who enjoy it. There's the people who just fall down and can't move. And you obviously just wanted to know if people felt.
You're a good guy, Lightning. You're a good guy, dude. We're going to miss you. We're going to miss you a lot. But B-Team listeners, you know, we've been talking about having a live remote. And I don't know when we're going to do that, but we are going to do a let's call it like a B-Team party machine. It's a going away party for Lightning. It's going to be called Lightning's
I Quit This Bitch
Party.
Wait, what's it called again? Do it again.
It's Lightning's
I Quit This Bitch
Party. March 10th at the Slide Bar, 8 p.m. There's no cover. We're all going to be there. Lightning, Dave, myself. I think Psycho Mike's going to be there. Yeah, Kevin Ryder's going to be there. I mean, except for the exception of Bean, I think the entire morning show is probably going to head
probably,
down there.
Yeah.
I'm sure Stryker's going to roll down. Nicole, Beer Mug. So we're all going to celebrate Lightning's career, and we're all going to have a good time. March 10th at the Slide Bar, 8 p.m. till whenever. They're going to have drink specials. It's going to be a good time. And let's show Lightning how appreciative we are
of
him.
If you ever enjoyed anything that Lightning did, whether it was from his commercials to his going across the country and bringing home a Christmas tree, a Kevin and Bean Christmas album, it was all our man Lightning.
Come and show some support and some love, and I'm gonna make sure that he does the hey, say ho thing.
And I'm gonna make sure he vomits.
It may take a couple of drinks.
Oh, that's easy.
That's gonna be so easy. So yeah, it's the Lightning
I Quit This Bitch
Party at the Slide Bar, March 10th. We hope to see you there. We're gonna post it on all our socials.
Yeah.
And come out and show our man Lightning some love. So because it's definitely
gonna
people
be going to. Do people care where I'm going? Should I tell people where I'm headed
care.
To?
Right.
I'm
totally
sure people
do.
Would like to
people,
check in with you from
absolutely.
Time to time.
Absolutely.
Why not?
Yeah.
I mean, I'm moving. I was given a really unique opportunity. You guys know I built that big truck a couple of years ago for K-Rock.
Yeah.
And
the
one
Rock
of,
Crusher.
Yeah, the Rock Crusher. It's a lifted dually. It's straight flat build. But like, I really had a great time interfacing with some of the sponsors of the vehicle. And one of those was Mr. Gale Banks. And Gale is a living legend in motorsports. And over
Banksy!
Not that Banksy. This guy is creative, yes. And they're celebrating their 60th year. And it is an incredibly revered company that make outstanding aftermarket products for cars and trucks and boats and all kinds of just amazing products. And I'm so thrilled to be given this opportunity to join their family. And there's a lot of parallels with K-Rock. It's a storied brand that people worship, like the way that they do K-Rock. You know, if you're into motorsports, you know Gale Banks. Like he's a legend. And I will be the brand manager for Banks Power, one of his divisions that make consumer products. I couldn't be more thrilled. So you can hit me. If you care, if you ever want to correspond, lightning@bankspower.com.
Yeah, and you can hit him up on Venmo at KROQKOM, you know,
That's yours.
No, but Lightning, they're really lucky to have you, man, because you're
absolutely
one of the hardest workers I know.
For
Thank
sure.
You.
Yeah, so.
We're going to miss you, Light.
Dude, I really appreciate you guys throwing the show for me. This is cool.
Yeah, man.
No,
and
this
then,
is really
yeah,
cool. This is your show, man. We're just doing it for you.
Everybody show to the
party, man. Yeah.
Everybody come out March 10th at the Slide Bar. It's going to be a good time. And, DJ Jeremiah Red's going to be there.
Oh, he is.
He's going to spin a set. So,
right
it's going to be awesome. Yeah, it's going
to
be
Say hi
time.
To me.
Yeah.
Lightning@bankspower.com. I
give me my backpack. From you.
Yeah, and give me my goddamn backpack.
The B Team. Yeah! The B Team. The B Team.
Oh, that's right.
The B Team. Baby!
Baby! Mm-hmm. I never say the baby part because it's me.
Yeah.
I don't like it.
You need to sing along with yourself.
I don't like it. It's weird.
I'm touched.
Yeah. We don't have an extra track, but I want to give you a minute or whatever. Take some time. Do you have a message for any of the listeners?
Yeah. Yeah, I guess I do. This building, these people are, you're actually make me well up. This is a really special radio station. This is a really, such a great group of people that, the things that it's, everyone here is working for something they believe in. There's no one here that's just coming in to collect a paycheck. It's been like that since.
Well, I'm
station.
Here too.
I mean, you are.
I wouldn't work for free.
Nah, but I mean, you would even take less money to work here.
Nah,
we all would.
I mean, we
and
have.
When you have.
It's true.
Everyone's taken hits recently and stuff. Anyway, it was never about the money with this place. It was always about passion and wanting to make playing the best music, making the funniest comedy, the most sincere connection with the audience. And I can't thank the K-Rock audience enough for as many stupid blunders as I've made all these years and laughable moments and stuff. They've been really kind. I want to thank everyone here. The list is way too long. Maybe I'll put it on Facebook. But there's been so many inspirations in this building from Mr. Weatherby, who's been my mentor, Kevin and Bean, who I love so dearly. You guys.
Feelings mutual.
Yep. It's just an incredible place, and I'm really excited about the future. The wonderful thing is now I get to be, I get to be a fan again. I get, because I started a fan, I will always be a fan. And I want it to continue to be the world famous K-Rock to me forever.
Awesome.
Well, just remember, you're not a fan, dude. You're family.
Yeah. Thank you.
I quit this bitch.
Thanks, Light. We love you.
Yeah, thank you, guys.
Introducing McDonald's new $1, $2, $3 menu with favorites for $1, $2, or $3. So now you can save for a
weekend getaway with the husband and kids?
Sure.
Especially if we leave the kids at home.
With grandma, of course. Build whatever meal you want with favorites on McDonald's new $1, $2, $3 menu.
Get any size soft drink for just $1. A 2-piece buttermilk crispy tender is only $2. Or a sausage McMuffin with egg, just $3. Prices and participation may vary. Cannot be combined with any other offer or combo meal.